We are back. You are here watching this video. It is the last day of 2020, and yes, I haven't posted in a couple of months, but it's been rough, guys. We're finally at the end of 2020. We survived the virus and all the times we were afraid for our lives, very unsure about the future, but we're finally at the end of 2020. No, the problems aren't done, but hey, we made it. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, and this is Wezi. We talk about things pertaining to life, most especially God, medicine, and generally just life and how much we can enjoy it whilst we're still on the earth. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button so you can get notifications every time I post. And yeah, welcome to the family. This is Wezi, or Chibochashe, the blueprint. So basically, this is how my year started.
Why? Stop asking me questions, I just wanna feel alive until I die. This is an ace flow, just
I have to tell you guys why I took a break from posting. I took a break because I thought that I wasn't being authentic with myself, because just so many things were happening in my heart with everything that happened in 2020. School getting moved to online, mission trips getting cancelled, me coming back home to Zambia, like everything was just happening so fast and everything just wasn't going as I had planned it or as I saw fit. I just felt it was very pretentious of me to actually just come here, share stuff about my life when all this is going on and I can't be honest about it. So I'm really, really sorry about that. I think I just had to process everything, and now that I'm out of it, or rather still dealing with it, but I'm much, much better, even with my own mental health and things that are going on around me, I feel like now is the time for me to actually post. This is just basically a video thanking you guys for all your support during this year. It's been rough, it's been tough. Thank you for being there for me. So I guess the big question is, what have I learned in 2020? I have learned especially that there is grace and there is room for mourning in God. I used to think that I have to be all perfect and all joyful and all, you know, just ignoring what's happening. But this year, honestly, I learned that even when things aren't going your way, when you lose people, I lost someone, and it was something that was very, very hard on me, but even more for the church and the family. And I heard God clearly say, it's okay for you to cry. You don't have to be strong. Even if you were praying for healing and really, really hoped for resurrection and all of that, and none of that happened, it's okay for you to mourn. God isn't afraid of your questions or anything like that. I learned to always put God first, because if you're seeking God, if you're running after God, if you're with God, nothing will surprise you. Well, to be honest, that used to be my perspective, like nothing will surprise me. God always shares his secrets with his friends and things like that. But then this year taught me God is above, God is supreme, God is above everything I can imagine. His ways are higher than mine, and his thoughts over me and everything else are much higher than mine. So when things that are surprising happen, I shouldn't be taken aback, but I should actually just cling on to God and trust Him and just know that things are going to be okay. Things are going to turn out all right, and that He always has your back. That's what I really, really learned this year. I learned that family should come before a lot of things that I had put in high esteem, for example. For example, I had put my thoughts of ministry way above my family, way above my friends. And God asked me a question about ministering to my family. And I said, honestly, Jesus, I would go anywhere in the world, but I don't want to be the one to have that responsibility of ministering to my family. And He asked me why, and He started taking me through that path. And He showed me the scripture in Timothy, which says, if I don't take care of my family, I'm actually worse than the unbeliever. And that just shocked me. And it's kind of put my own heart and my vision into perspective, that in as much as I would like to reach the world, I should be willing to actually reach my family first and be kind to my family. And I'm not just meaning like my brothers and my parents. No, I'm talking about my family in general, people around me, because God actually looks at the small things, how we use them, how we utilize them. He can't trust you with a lot of things if you can't even utilize the small things. Don't despise humble beginnings. If you can't manage the things around you, how are you going to manage if God gives you even bigger things? Yeah, that was a really, really, really tough lesson for me. This year, I also learned the importance of friends. Being at Bethel just created this whole new environment for me to kind of grieve and mourn what was happening and just be aware of it and attack it head on instead of avoiding it and just ignoring it. It actually gave me the opportunity. My friends were there to help me, you know, just get things head on and not avoid them. And I saw the beauty in friends in that the Holy Spirit really used them to actually minister to me in so many ways. When I was hurting, when I was angry, when I was upset, when I was broken, when I was hurt, He really used my friends. And this is why we should always surround ourselves with people who believe in God, people who trust God, people who you are easily yoked to, so that you can run with them. Yes, running with them. Another thing I learned in 2020 is taking responsibility for where I have made mistakes, for where I have gone wrong, for what I have done wrong. Just taking responsibility for myself. God took me through this journey where I had to basically like take responsibility, be it in past relationships, in friendships, in family. Like, what parts did I play? How could I have done better? And things like that. Just reviewing the times, and that brought so much healing to my heart and so much peace to my soul, and it brought reconciliation to me and a lot of people, my family and also my friends, and I'm so grateful for that. Once again, I'm so grateful for you guys who are out there, who I have never met but still continue to engage with me, especially on Instagram. I have gotten tremendous number of messages of people who have come to my channel and they reached out, be it to know something concerning medical practice, med school, or God and how we live each and every day. I just want to tell you guys that even if 5 people see your video, it would have changed at least one person's heart. I've learned not to look at views, not to look at the numbers. There's that temptation of always comparing yourself, like, oh, I've been doing YouTube, I've been doing Facebook lives for this amount of time and only this number of people are viewing what my content, whilst other people are engaging in other people's content even more than yours. There was that temptation and I faced it a lot, especially during this COVID pandemic season, especially during lockdown. But I have learned to focus on your goal, focus on your assignment, focus on what you are given to do. Don't look around. It's going to be you and God when you go to heaven. He's literally going to look at you and say, I gave you this, I assigned you to this, I mandated you for this, but what did you do with it? And then you'll be like, oh no, but but Kitasia was doing this, but Mocha was doing this. Like, no, I gave you this assignment. So this year, this coming year, guys, be original, be authentic, be yourself, and go for what God has for you. I love you so much.